So, here we are to a new video. If you see my other videos, I quite often use my terminal. I'm under Linux, so this is a bash shell. And today I will show you some commands that can speed up your workflow. These are some commands I get up really new, or there are some that I use quite for a few years. So first of all, the best part on this shell is it has a history. So you don't have to type in every command. For example, if I type in pvd for the current directory, I only use the up arrow to get the last command, and I can use them through all my history. So every command I type in every time is in this list. So this makes it easy to find a command you have used a few weeks ago. You can type in history, and that is a list with all the last command. To execute one of these commands, you'll use the exclamation mark. So for example, if you want to execute the last command, or say the command 2000, simply type in and it execute this command. And there's some nice trick. You can use the double exclamation mark to execute the last command. So this will execute this one. And this is not that special, but you can make a nice shortcut. For example, you want to update your package and you forget to use sudo to get administration right. You can simply type in sudo and use this to get the last command, enter your password, and there it is. So this is this technique or this command I use quite often. I often forget to type in sudo, so I can use the up arrow and get out of the first position and type in sudo, but for me it's quite easier if I use sudo and this, and I think it's really nice to use it this way. So this was the first thing I find really interesting. The second one is the history have already a search function. I don't know this, and I was quite impressed. So it's Control R to get to your search, and then you can type in your search pattern, any command you have used in the last time. For me, maybe something like this, if I have something to do with my videos. And to get all these search results for this pattern, simply type in Control R to loop through them. And if you find the right command, press enter and it will be executed. Yeah, quite simple, and I have found out with earlier, but I didn't search for it. So that was everything about the history. Now there are some commands I find interesting if you want to make sure that the command will be executed. So for example, you run some script or everything that will integrate with your user and ask, are you sure you want to execute this, are you sure you want to leave this, and type in yes or J. And there's the command yes. This will simply type in the Y every time it's need. So you can use the pipe, and for example, I don't know if there's anything. Oh yes, at some point he asked me if I'm sure I want to install these updates, and I don't have to enter Y. It's simply the yes command did this for me. And so maybe if you want to automate something and write a script where you don't want extra user integration, you can use this nice little command. So after the yes command, I will show you one basic command, and you will be laughing. It's a change directory command. So cd for change directory to the home directory. If I type, you see I'm in my home directory. And now, for example, I will change to my project folder, for example, and some project I'm working on. And now, obviously, I'm with directory, and with cd I can go back, and now I'm in my home directory. There's nothing special until now. So now if I want to go back to my project directory, I simply type in the up arrow and I'm there. This is not that complicated, but maybe I have typed in some other commands, or maybe I'm not in my home directory, in this other directory, and want to go back to my last directory, I can type in cd and minus, and I go back to my last directory. And yeah, I don't know that this exists, and it's a small and really simple command, but I think this small difference makes the difference between a beginner and a pro. I'm not a pro, I won't say that, but this can maybe change me if I learn more. So, and by the way, I think there are a lot of other commands. Maybe you know some. You know something I have to learn, or you have a good page where I can found something, write a comment. If you learn something new or you find this interesting, please like and share this video. I'm really sure I will make a second video with much more commands. This was only the first few were up in my head. Yeah, have a nice day, and we will see you soon.